In this video, we're going to talk about the GitHub authentication. So how GitHub administration is working. So now, basically GitHub do have a personal access tokens and username and password to log in. So that's the way that you do the setup. Now, there is something called GitHub administration. Let me post it over here and explain you in detail. So as a GitHub administrator, so your goal is to keep everything working smoothly for your users. In this particular video, you will be learning about different organizational hierarchy and how the administration is working. Now, I have already touched upon this administration before, like how I created the Teams thing. So go back to the team section and identify how I spoke about the particular teams and how I manage the particular repository. Now, in GitHub, each user is an organization member that you can add to a particular team. So let me go and show you a glimpse about that. Now over here, you can see how I manage the project. So when you come out of it, you can see teams of option over here. So each team has their own responsibility and they have their own visibilities over here. So you can see their particular role. Now you can even filter by maintainer, filter by member or something like that. And a cute picture over here as well. All right. So additionally, GitHub allows you to sync your teams with the identity provider, such as Microsoft Entra ID. This is a next level of authentication in terms of GitHub administration. So Microsoft Entra ID. So let me go and show you Microsoft Entra ID. So this is like another layer of security. Again, if you are not an organization level manager, you don't really need this. And again, this is like a very pricey one. Per individual users, they will be giving a price for it. So this will allow us to manage the entire organization in one single click. So what happens over here is like, I have to manually create an individual team. Now, in order to remove one person, I have to manually go here and remove it. And I have to manually change their access to this particular organization. By using the Entra ID, this becomes much more easy in such a way that you can manage their settings over here. So when you go to the settings over here, so this is how we manage the particular code reviews, things and everything. But with Entra ID, it is much more easy. So that's the overall idea over here. Now in a repository permission level, these are the access available to each individual team, which is like read, they can read, track, which is like proactively you can do manage issues and pull requests without the write access. Now, when you give a write access, they can do a pull request and do a write permission. Now, maintainer, they do have a kind of access to a, they don't have access to sensitivity data, like delete your repository, delete any files or something, but they can overall maintain and manage your pull request in your repository. And admin, they do have a same restrictive actions. They can delete your repository and all these things. So make sure that which role you're assigning to your open source contributor over here. Now, permission levels are two types. So one is like a member. The team members have the same set of abilities. A maintainer, he is a person who can edit and delete team discussions, promote the teams into another people, and do a code review and manage the schedule reminders or pull requests. So that's what happening over here. And this been happening in organization level, enterprises level, and team level. These all are different. So in the below description, there is like a complete description about how this been happening. Now that's a bit of theoretical thing, so I don't want to touch it up over there. So this is how it looks for the organization permission level. So there will be a permission level owner. This is what they can do. Billing manager, security managers, outside collaborator, moderator, and member. So this is like again a theory level of understanding how the access to the permission level inside your repository looks like in terms of organization. Now this is the permission level for the particular building manager, all right? And this is like, again, we already spoke about the protection rules. So this allows, this protection rules allows to have a require pull request before merging. So if I am the owner of this particular organization, then every pull request is going to merge should have my pull request as must before merging. Otherwise, it won't let you to merge by anyone, whoever has admin access as well. Now, require status check for passing before merging. So all these things can be done using protection rules. Now, in action, I will show each one of things how it can be done. Now, before jumping into the permission level, I want to touch upon a few more things like how the permission looks like and how the organization permission and how it's different. Now, here we spoke about different organization permission. So this is for organization and this is for teams and this is for the normal repository permission. So this is how it looks like, okay? All right, now that's all from this particular theory-based video. I know this theory-based videos are mostly boring. Now pause the video for a moment and try to answer this particular question. So you want to grant a user the permission required to add or remove organization thing. So which permission you would be grant that user? So it should be like team maintainer. Now, as an organization owner, you want to ensure that everyone who is signed into your corporate network can access the GitHub website without requiring a second sign-in. Which technology would you enable and accomplish this? So single sign-on, right? What's the appropriate repository permission level for contributor who need to actively push changes into your repository, right? All right, so this is the small quiz to understand where you are. Now, what type of user authentication is used to verify user identity again? A non-identity provider. So this is a bit tricky. So we have not touched upon this yet. So basically single sign-on is the one thing answer. And you are an admin and want to enable team synchronization for your organization. What installation permission do you need to configure team synchronization for Microsoft Entra ID? Read all users full profile. All right. Okay, let me see. Okay, this is for your next thing, how you can do the code suggestions and everything. So see you in the next video with the pull request status. Thank you for watching this video.